The federal environment minister says he stopped the clock on a Chinese government-owned coal mine awaiting government approval. The decision has come after concerns were raised by farmers about the mine's proximity to prime agricultural lands and just weeks before an approval was expected.
The Liverpool Plains in northern New South Wales are home to some of the nation's most productive farming. Wheat, barley, sorghum and cotton grow in abundance.
These soils here are some of the most fertile soils in Australia.
Farmers in the region are afraid the land and water could be compromised if a $1.2 billion Chinese-owned coal mine is allowed to go ahead.
It's taken millions of years for these soils to get here and millions of years for the aquifers that are below here to form. But a 30-year mine could put all of that at risk.
For tens of thousands of years, too, these lands have been the home to first Australians. And some traditional owners are dismayed over what they say was a lack of consultation over their ancestral lands.
Aboriginal history is a whole of Australian history. You know, it's for everyone. It's, you know, and all these significant areas here, you know, it's our home these significant areas are in. And we don't want them touched, we don't want them destroyed.
A site survey conducted during the planning phase of the project uncovered 55 Aboriginal archaeological sites, including a series of grinding grooves worn into the rock. The grooves are located within the area earmarked to be dug up during construction.
The grinding grooves, for those who don't know, is the Aboriginal workshop. And putting it bluntly, how would the white community like if I got on a dozer and went and dozed their workshops down?
Shenhua plans to temporarily remove the artefacts and replace them when the mining pit is rehabilitated in around 20 years.
You can't just cut it up and move it aside and put it back. The impact is enormous.
Farmer John Habersham believes the impact on his Breeza property will also be enormous. The Shenhua Watermark site sits on a ridge just beyond his farm. The mine's management says its planned operations won't harm the fertile black soil that makes the plains especially good for growing crops.
And we are 100% in the ridge country, mining in the ridge country, in the red soil areas, in the areas which is not used for cropping. And our intent was never to be on the black soil plains.
But environmentalists are worried about the impact to the area's struggling koala population. Shenhua says it plans to plant trees to replace habitat and food sources lost during construction. The Gunnedah region has a 100-year history with coal mining. There are at least half a dozen already in the region. But at 15,000 hectares, Shenhua's Watermark project will be the largest.
We could potentially become the largest employer in the Gunnedah. So we will have a major impact on this town economically.
The New South Wales government has given the project a green light, but it still needs federal approval. That's now been delayed, with Environment Minister Greg Hunt calling for greater scrutiny into possible threats to groundwater. Rhiannon Elston, NITV News.